I first want to note that this ordinance amendment doesn't legalize anything. It's an attempt to further decriminalize the adult private use of marijuana. And decriminalize, which we've done already, but this takes the penalty even lower. Means that it's treated like a minor traffic violation. And I have some things I'd like to say in background. Marijuana is the third most popular recreational drug in the United States. It's behind alcohol and tobacco. Some figures I found said that nearly 100 million people in the U.S. have partaken of marijuana at some time. 38 million in the last year, and that there are 14 million people in the U.S. who partake in marijuana regularly. I think there are disagreements about this, but it seems to be mostly regarded, or many people regard it as a soft drug, which would put it in the category with alcohol and tobacco. And as a soft drug, many have argued that it's not a criminal, it shouldn't be a criminal matter, but it should be, it's a health matter, like alcohol and tobacco are. And I'm the first one to say that I know that marijuana has its health issues. So unless it's harming other people, I would argue that it does need to be a health matter, and that it's all right for adults to use marijuana privately. The government has had what we could call a war on marijuana, along with the war on drugs, on harder drugs, and many people who've done research, and I too believe that there's been created a false equivalency of marijuana with hard drugs. And what concerns me about the false equivalency is that it does damage credibility of the jurisdiction or the government regarding hard drugs, because marijuana is de facto, I mean, it is, despite being illegal, it is the one of the three top recreational substances in this country. The worry is that people who know that in fact it's different from cocaine or meth or heroin or some of those nasty substances out there, that perhaps they're not believing the so-called experts about cocaine or the bad drugs, because they know that marijuana is not in the same category in terms of health risks. There have been studies that show that marijuana as a gateway drug is simply not true. Some people have called it a big lie, but there are many studies that show that marijuana use is not causally connected to hard drug use. There is a relationship, but it's not necessarily a causal relationship. And I know in talking with members of our police department, you all see some pretty horrible situations in which marijuana is included. But statistically, in a large way, marijuana does not lead to hard drug use. Actually, they found that the first drug that leads to hard drug use is usually alcohol. I believe police officers when they say they've walked into homes for reasons and seen marijuana and seen horrible conditions for families. I would guess that no one here in this room right now is currently under the influence of any hard drugs. Or probably never under the influence of any hard drugs. But I'm not gonna ask people to raise their hands. It would be interesting to ask and find out how many people here have ever partaken in marijuana, but I'm not gonna ask that. Marijuana is legal in 9 states. It's decriminalized in 14. It's used for medical, it's allowed for medical reasons in 30 states. In a fall Gallup poll, 2/3 of Americans supported the legal use of marijuana. And I believe that we need to get real about accepting marijuana's place in our culture, because it is already there in our culture. And so I offered this ordinance amendment as a very small step in that direction.